Good morning, students and dear students. Today, in this part of video, I would like to teach about what is the prism and how to determine refractive index of a prism experimentally. Listen very carefully. So what is our concept? What is the prism and how to determine refractive index of the prism experimentally? So generally, okay, in this concept mainly three terms are important or involved: angle of prism, second one angle of deviation, and third one angle of minimum deviation. So these three terms I will be explained in the concept of how to determine refractive index of prism experimentally. Okay, so first of all, I will give a brief idea about what is the prism. Prism is made up of a transparent material like glass. In the glass also different one: plinth glass, ordinary glass, ground glass, like that one is there. But anyone, so prism is a transparent material. It is bounded by number of surfaces. Listen very carefully. Prism is a transparent material bounded by number of surfaces is there. But the prism will be contained. Okay, I will first draw the diagram. So it is a simple diagram of the prism. Here we are observing that the prism will be contained mainly two triangular shape of the base of the prism. That's why prism will be contained two triangular bases. This is one base and this is the another base of the prism. These both are opposite shape, triangular shape, and also it will be having three so means here one, two, back side, three. Totally, so the prism will be having how many? Three, reflecting surfaces. Or refracting simply, because of when the light will be fall on here, it will become outside. Okay, so that's why three, reflecting plane surfaces. So listen very carefully. Totally, a prism will be having how many? One, five. Okay. Two are triangular bases and three are reflecting plane surfaces. This is one reflecting one. This is the second one. This is the third one. Okay. So once again, listen very carefully. Prism is transparent material made up of a glass and it is bounded by number of faces. So but generally the a prism will be okay in case of a equilateral prism. So it will be having two triangular bases and three reflecting plane surfaces. Determine refractive index of prism experimentally. So actually under this concept, how to find refractive index of a prism, under this one, so we have the two methods are there. One is experimental method and the second one is derivative method. So first we discuss the experimental method and later we discuss about the derivative method. So how to determine the which one refractive index of the prism? Refractive index means mu. Okay, so that is we know very clearly, it is represented by the symbol. Now we discuss about this one, how to find. So we know that if we can conduct the any experiment, we must be want some materials. That's why what are the materials are required to us? First that is we discuss in that. Okay. So it is the rough diagram of which one means okay prism. So, what are the materials required to find the refractive index of a prism or determine the refractive index of a prism experimentally? Drawing chalk, drawing board, glass prism, four pins, protractor, ruler, pencil, etc. These are the main materials are required to conduct this experiment. Now, how we can conduct this experiment? We discussed it step by step in this time. So, first of all, we can take a drawing sheet. It is fixed on the drawing board, and the four corners of the drawing chart is fixed with umbrella pins. Listen very carefully. First of all, we can take the white drawing chart. It is fixed on the drawing board with help of the four umbrella pins at its four corners. Why? Because of means without disturbing, moving, changing the position of the paper to avoid the moving of the paper. After that, now we can take the prism, glass prism. The prism is placed at the middle of the drawing chart. And draw its boundaries simply. Draw the boundaries of a prism. Now remove the prism and show its car. Corners are vertices, we can say as P, Q, R. I can say that P, Q, R. So P, Q, R. Now after that, so now we can take the, which one? Protractor. Here, listen very carefully. The prism will be having how many refractive surfaces? Two. One is the PQ, another one is the PR. Listen very carefully. So, every prism will be contained how many refracting surfaces? Two. One is the PQ, another one is the PR. Reflecting plane surfaces are three are there, two triangular base prisms are there. But among three reflecting plane surfaces, so two are, according to the placing of the prism, they are acts as a refracting surfaces. That's why. So the prism will be having two refracting surfaces. One is the PQ, another one is the PR. Now, with help of the protractor, on the protractor, AB line is there. The AB line will be exactly placed along the PQ, first side, like this one. So, by using the protractor, we make the normal and incident ray by taking the 30 degrees angle. That's why. So, for this protractor, it is the 90. At this point, we put one dot. And also, we make the angle of incident. What is the 30 degrees? That's why here 90 means 60. At the 60, we put one dot. That's why 90 minus 60, 30 degrees. After that, remove the protractor from their position. And now, join this dot to the which one? PQ surface. Or, we draw an imaginary perpendicular line that is must be flying to the PQ that is passing through the normal. This is the normal. And from this point, we draw one line. That line is must be passing through the incident one. Means another pin. This is the incident ray. Listen very carefully. After placing the prism in the, at the middle of the paper, we draw the boundaries of the prism. Now remove the prism. By placing a protractor, we can make the normal and incident. Like this one. So now after that, on the incident ray, we place the two pins in vertical mode. That is X and Y. We are considered that anyone as your wish. So now we can take the two pins. The two pins you fix on the incident ray, in vertical mode, the distance between the 2 cm is not exceeded, 5 cm. After completion of this one, now the prism will be placed within the boundary, like PQR, and come to the other side of the prism, and observing the incident ray and the two pins, if this ray will be come outside through the PR, listen very carefully. For example, if we can take a laser light, the laser light will be focused on the prism at PQ. So it will be fall on this one. What will be happen? at the PQ, first it will be refracted. That's why. So this is the normal, just we can say that. What we know that very clearly, if the light will be travel from rarer to denser medium. Why? Because of here, which is medium is present here A, it is the prism is glass. It is denser medium. That's why if the light is travel from rarer medium to denser medium, we know that it will bend towards the normal. That's right. So it is the normal means bend towards the normal. Okay. So and again it will be fall onto the PR surface, and for the PR surface the light will behaves as to travel from denser to rarer. That's at this point we draw another normal. For this one it will be move away from the normal. So listen very carefully. So instead of these two things, first discussing that if we can place a laser, okay, focus the laser light on the PQ surface, the laser light at the PQ behaves as to travel from rarer to denser. That's why light is deviated from its path and moves towards the normal. And again, it will passing through the inside the prism because of it is a transparent. That's why it will be again fall onto the second refracting surface at the PQ. For the PR, the light ray behaves as to travel from denser to rarer. That's why it will be moved away from that one. So here you are observing that, okay, the part of the light in the side of PQ, it is called incident ray. The part of the light, okay, inside the okay prism here, okay, according to this one, BC is called refracted ray and CD is called emergent ray. So incident ray, refracted ray, and emergent ray. Emergent is nothing but come outside. That is the way of that one. That's why what is our concept here? So on the incident ray we fix the two pins x and y. Now we can come to the PR side or other refracting surface of the prism, and by observing these two pins on incident ray, if this incident ray by passing like this one, it will become outside through the one PR surface. That is you are located, okay, imaginarily with help of the two pins. That's why now we can take the another two pins. The two pins will be fixed in the side of the PQ exactly all are lie in the same okay straight line. Which are lie? Okay, these two pins and these two pins. Okay, in our previous way I said that okay here it is the X, it is the Y, it is the R, it is the S. That's why S R Y means S pin, R pin, Y pin, X pin. S, R, Y, X. Because of you can see from which one S. S to next to R in the view of our eye. R to next to Y. Y to X. That's why. So means so after fixing the two pins on the incident ray, you can come to the other side. So with help of these two pins on the incident ray, it will become outside through the PR as an emergent ray. That is, you are located with help of the another two pins. The two pins will be fixed in the PR side. Okay, and so you observing that the four pins are appears in a straight line, then okay, you are doing this one exactly. That's why when the four pins are appears and appears in a straight line. So remove the two pins and draw the circles. Now remove the prism from there. Okay, within from the boundary of the prism. After that, these two circles are joined with a straight line and extended up to the PR. Where it will meet the PR at that part, we draw a normal. That's why it is the incident ray. This part is gives the refracted ray. This part will be gives the emergent ray. So here we know that the angle between incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. The angle between normal and refracted ray is called angle of refraction. Like the same way, the angle between emergent ray and normal is called angle of emergency. That is angle D. Okay. For the same angle of incident, we can reverse the experiment. Reverse the experiment means this side is incident ray, this side is the emergent ray. So at that time you are observing that the light will be follow the principle of reversibility. Principle of reversibility. What is mean by principle of reversibility? I said very clearly in the chapter of refraction of light at plane surfaces. Okay, the path of the light is does not change. That is called principle of reversibility. So here, for example, angle I is 30. We can draw one line. Okay, so incident ray, refracted ray, emergent ray. Now the same. We are considering the incident ray. It is incident ray for the same here, which angle 30. Here is also can take the same 30 angle, incident ray, refracted. It is the emergent ray. That's why the path of the light is does not change for the same angles on the both sides, according to the principle of reversibility. That's why what? Okay, so angle I1 is represented angle of incident. I2 is represented the angle of incident C. So finally, after that, now we can find the angle of the prism. We know that what is angle of the prism? The angle between these two vertices is like this one. Okay, so that's why the angle between these two lines, this one, is called what is that one? Angle of the prism. So finally, the values are substituted in the mu equals to. But here, one more thing is also there. I forgot it. A little bit now. So before going to the other topic in this one, for continuation, once again, listen. First of all, we can take a drawing chart. It is fixed on a drawing board. Now we can take the prism. It will be placed exactly at the middle of the drawing sheet and draw the boundaries. Now remove the prism. With help of the protractor, we make the normal and incident angle 30 degrees. After that, on the incident ray, we put the two pins in vertical mode. Now place the prism exactly within the boundary. Now we can come to the PR side, and you are observing the two pins and okay, this incident ray. If this incident ray will become outside through the PR as an emergent ray, that is you are located with help. Okay, drawn with help of the by placing the another two pins R and S. So in this one, the XY RS pins, all the pins are up as straight line, then we can do the experiment. Exactly. After that, remove the pins at the RS and draw the circles, and remove the prism from the boundaries. And now these two circles are joined with a straight line and extended up to the PR. So where they will be meet at that point, we draw the normal for this one. The angle between emergent ray and normal is called angle of emergency R I2. Now we can repeat the same experiment here. But one more thing is important here. What is that one means? It is the incident ray. The incident ray will be extended forward and the emergent ray will be extended backward. Okay, where these two are meet at that point, what will be formed? Angle of deviation. So I said very clearly in our previous video. What is angle of deviation? The angle between emergent ray and incident ray. That's why here, this is the emergent ray, this is the incident ray. This angle we are called what is it called? Angle of deviation. That's why if angle I is 30 at the time, what is the deviation angle? That is your noted. Like the same way, you can repeat the same experiment. Okay. Angle I, angle delta, angle E, angle of incident, angle of deviation, and angle of emergency. Okay. So mainly these two, this is not important to us, angle of emergency. That's why these two are very important. Angle I is, for example, 30. Just okay. Next, 35, 40, 45, 50. Okay, totally 5 values you are considered that here. Half up to 55 also no problem. So 30 means 31. Again, 34, 37, like this one. It is not exact values, just for understanding of you. But during experiment, okay, values are slightly changes, like this type of mode. Angle I is 30, okay, deviation angle is 31, 35, 33, 40, 36, 45, 29 or 30, 50, 34, 55, 37. So, means now we can repeat the same experiment by taking the different angle of incident and regarding deviation angles. After that, we draw or plot a graph. So, in the graph, angle of incident values we have taken along the x-axis. And angle of deviation values we have taken along the y-axis. Listen very carefully. We can plot a graph by taking angle of incident on the x-axis and angle of deviation is taken on the y-axis. So that's why here incident is there 0. Just we can consider that I is 5, or maybe for example, okay, 5, 10. 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. So angle is more, that's why. Like this one, we have said that. Okay. So here, on the y-axis, angle of deviation. So angle of deviation values mostly 29 to 37. That's why here what we have said that same. Okay. For example, 10, 20. So it is 5. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. So here you are observing that 30, 31, 30 is here, 31 means like this. Yes. 33, 34, for example, 32, 31, 20. 8. Okay, so 30 is 34, 35, 32. So here, after that, Okay, like this one. That is, I will be drawn simply for understanding of it. No need to write these values because of we are not conducting any experiment during the examination. That's why simply we can draw the diagram. Deviation value will be decreases after reaches to one particular value. So the angle of deviation is increases along with increasing the angle of incident. That's why at what angle of incident, okay, so the deviation angle is small, or at what angle of deviation the graph is again moving to up, okay, so that is called minimum deviation angle. Listen very carefully. So angle of minimum deviation or deviation angle means, okay, so at what angle of incident the deviation angle value is very small, okay, at what angle of incident the deviation angle value is small, that is called angle of deviation, that is D of M. So according to the, our value 28 or 29 is the angle of deviation. Regularly when you are doing that experiment, either you can get either 28 or 29 for 45. That's why that is the angle of deviation. So from the prism, so by make, okay, by finding the angle between these two, we can find the angle of prism. And from the graph, we can find which one minimum deviation angle. And finally, these values are substituted in the formula mu is equals to sine a plus dm upon 2 by sine a by 2. So by using this formula, you can find refractive index of a prism experimentally. Mu is the refractive index of the prism. Sine of A is the angle of prism. Dm is the angle of minimum deviation. So upon sine A by 2. So this is the formula. How we can derive this formula, that is we discuss in the coming next video. Now once again listen very carefully, okay, but when they are asking this type of, okay, this question during the examination, what we can write and which diagrams you draw means these two diagrams you draw, okay. So first I will draw clearly this diagram. So this is the prism, this one here. So first of all, we can take a drawing sheet. It is fixed on the drawing board. Means before this one, first you can write what are the materials are required to conduct this experiment. Already we know that very clearly. After that, so under the procedure, what you can write, take a drawing sheet, it is fixed on the drawing board. Now we can take a prism, it is fixed on the drawing, it is placed on the drawing sheet and draw the boundaries and remove the, prism from the paper and we are that vertices we have tensor as PQR. Now we can take the protractor. With help of the protractor is placing in the side of the PQ, and we draw a normal and angle of incidence 30 degrees. Right. Now we fix the two pins, or now we can place the two pins on the incident ray in vertical mode. After that, the prism will be placed within the boundary and come to the PR side. And now we can draw the emergent ray. It's nothing but the incident ray will become outside through the PR. In what direction will become? With help of the another two pins, you are drawing the emergent ray. So at that time, so the four pins are appears in a same order in a straight line. Then you can do the experiment perfectly. After that, remove the two pins and draw the circuits and remove the prism also. Now these two circuits are joined with a straight line and extended up to the PR, where we will meet. At that point we draw a normal. So this ray is called emergent ray. So now in this one, the angle between incident ray and normal, we know that angle of incident. The angle between emergent ray and normal is called angle of emergency. Now the emergent ray is produced backward and the incident ray is produced forward. These two are meet at one point. At that point, one angle will be formed, that is called deviation angle. Because of we know that the angle between emergent ray and incident ray is called angle of deviation. That's why this deviation angle is also we have noted. Now repeat the same experiment by taking the different angle of incident and noted the corresponding or find the corresponding angle of deviation. And finally, so now we can plot the graph by using the angle of incident and angle of deviation value. So angle of incident value is taken on the x-axis and angle of deviation values are taken on the y-axis. And if you can plot the graph is appears like a curved position. So from this graph we can find the minimum deviation angle. At the minimum deviation angle, I1 is equals to I2, R1 is equals to R2. That is explained in the tomorrow. Next one, how to determine the refractive index. Means how to prove this peak formula, that is one. Now after that, so from the diagram we can find the angle of prism, and from this one we can find the from the graph you can find the angle of minimum deviation. These two values are substituted in this formula. So mu equals to sine of a plus dm upon 2 upon sine a by 2. So in this formula we substitute the angle of the prism and the minimum deviation angle. So then you can find the refractive index of the prism experimentally. Thank you.